Welcome back. In the previous episode, we saw how to handle the Dante setup for RUio16-D. It's a sound engineer's best mate, a link to bring plug-in processing to any Dante audio network. Now, I will show you how to handle the patching from your mixing desk and how to connect the unit with the VST Rack Pro software. After this, you'll be ready to apply the VST3 plugins and hear their effect on your mix. The most popular use of plugins will be to insert them on a range of input channels. RUio16-D allows 16 mono or up to 8 stereo. Let's first see how to do it with a Dante MY16 AUD2 card in slot 1. So this method will work with the widest range of consoles. CL series, QL series, PM5D, M7CL, LS9, DM2000, DM1000, and more. Even Rivage PM series. Though of course, that already has a huge range of these plugins inside as standard. So, select the first input or output channel you wish to insert the plugins to. Look at the selected channel view and open the insert window. Choose the insert position, pre-EQ, pre-fader, or post-fader. Pre-fader would be the most likely position to insert EQ and dynamics plugins. Then select slot 1-1 as the send port. And select slot 1-1 as the return in port. Switch the insert on. Do the same for the next channel, but this time, of course, for slot 1, port 2. And switch it on. And carry on through all the other channels you wish to treat with additional plugins, until all the 16 ports are used. Now, it's worth noting that QL series consoles allow the built-in Dante ports to be used for inserts, so you might not need an MY card if you have enough vacant ports. However, CL series mixers will not allow inserts to be patched via its built-in Dante port, so a Dante MY card will be required. Also note that TF series consoles don't include an external insert facility and don't have any MY slots, so a different method will be needed. With TF series, if you have an NY64D card, you could use an input channel's direct out feature to transmit and then receive the return into a spare input channel. Another patch method that will work with all the consoles is to make a send and return patch for additional reverbs, delays, and other time-based effects. In that case, select a mix bus and set its output patch to a spare Dante port. Then the returning Dante port can be patched to an input channel to use as an effects return. Also, you could send a mix output or matrix or stereo master straight out to the RUio16-D for final processing or mastering before sending it on to another Dante device for output to amplifiers, recording, or live streaming equipment. You don't have to return the signal back into the mixing desk. Anyway, once the patch is made on the console, you may wish to store it into a scene memory. Then it will be time to check the USB connection between the RUio16-D and the host computer and launch VST Rack Pro. Now you might have the question, if I'm using Dante controller software to set up the device in the first place, why not use Dante Virtual Sound Card for the audio, rather than the USB port? Well, it's a good thought, but actually, USB is going to provide a quicker route for the audio through the computer. Dante Virtual Sound Card has quite a high latency, so you'll find it's not practical for live sound inserts. Though, of course, it's great for multi-track recording. If you're planning to use the same computer for configuring the Dante network and running VST Rack, do make sure to disable Dante Virtual Sound Card before running VST Rack. To ensure there are no clock sync conflicts and to maximize the available resources for the plugins. Remember, the plugins are processed in the computer, not in the RUio16-D. Before inserting all the gorgeous plugins, take a quick look at the VST Rack Settings menu and the Hardware window. Make sure the audio device is set to Yamaha RUio16-D. On Mac OS, select the High Precision option to access parameters specific to VST Rack Pro. Pressing Setup will show the audio latency in and out of the computer. This depends on the setting selected within the control panel, so open that to adjust the buffer size. Try the minimum number of samples to start with, that is 32. If the computer cannot cope and the audio suffers, try a higher setting, though it will start to increase the latency, so it may be a better idea to upgrade your computer. But at least you can keep an eye on your computer's performance with the average and peak meters at the top of the window. Check the sample rate shown is the expected value. It must be the same rate used by the other digital audio components in your system. By the way, let me explain a couple of the RUio16-D's front panel features, which are actually quite nicely displayed by the signal flow diagram on the top. Firstly, the bypass USB switch. If this is lit red, the Dante inputs will route straight back out. Use that in case your computer has trouble, or if you want to quickly compare the sound with and without plugins. In fact, bypass will automatically activate if the VST rack gets closed or detects trouble with the computer, keeping the audio alive. And for that to work as seamlessly as possible, there is a bypass USB level adjustment for each channel, where you can ensure the bypassed signal level closely matches the processed signal level. Set that while referencing the level difference indicator in the hardware window. Secondly, if there's a front panel connection in these front panel inputs, they will take over channels 15 and 16 from Dante. It allows you to both send these analog inputs through a Dante network and also insert some plugins before returning to the analog output. For example, use it across the stereo master of an analog console with some tasty EQ compression and mastering. You would need this monitor Dante USB switch set to USB in that case. If you're not using the analog inputs, set this monitor Dante USB switch to monitor. Then you'll be able to hear any channel you cue in the VST Rack Pro software from the analog outputs and from the headphone socket. Well, that's all we have time for in this video. Join me in the next episode when I'll show you how to use a sample project and some of the provided rack presets, along with some other tips to help you enjoy a more creative approach to audio processing. See you soon.